Hi guys, how are y'all? Hope y'all are doing well. I know I've been gone for so long and I don't really have an excuse. I did do a lot of stuff. I went to India, so I have a lot of content. And I wasn't sure if anybody was missing me. I guess those are excuses. You know, I don't know if you guys missed me. I missed myself on YouTube. But yeah, and because I don't get a lot of comments, I don't know what's going on. But I did see that I still got some 6 or 7 subscribers. I know that's really low, but for me, it's good. Slowly but surely, we're working towards a wholesome number. So yeah, in this video, the lead up to the India vacation. I'll just show you what I've been doing and certain things to keep in mind, and how things turn out. So if you're preparing for an India trip, I hope this will be useful in some way. So I hope you like this video. If you do, give it a like. So guys, many years ago, my kids clogged up my parents' bathroom because we were using the Indian toilet paper, and the Indian toilet paper is like tearing a page out of a notebook and using it. It's a little hard. So ever since then, my parents have been like, please bring your own toilet paper and leave our toilets alone. So if you were to ask me, I would say that good toilet paper is also another example of American exceptionalism, and Ziploc being the other one, as I've mentioned earlier. Well, I don't know if I could now ever go back to no toilet paper. But you know, as an Indian American, we're just optimizing on life here, because we've got the Indian style and we've got the American style. So even here, I have a Toto kind of thing. So there is the water, a bidet facility, and then there's toilet paper. I'm telling you, we're just killing it. We know how to live. Lately, guys, for all my long distance trips, I always buy this jet lag tablets, and I bought this from Whole Foods, and I think you can also get it on Amazon. Never travel without it. It's homeopathic. You can check with your doctor. I didn't, and it worked for me. That's just my personal experience, because I don't do well with jet lag. So when I have this, I don't know if it's placebo or what, but it works. If you are a plant lover, you have to make arrangements for your plants and have someone come and water it as well.
So guys, what I did was that I brought all the plants that I had in the house from upstairs, from all the other rooms, and I put it here. I have a snowboarding kind of a thing underneath, so that, you know, some of these drip. So I don't want my wood floors to get ruined, because I'm having a few different people do it. So I don't know how careful they'll all be. So I bought all my plants here and by this lovely French window. So I think it'll get enough sunlight over here. And already toppled one plant. That's the orchid. This one was, I bring it over here because it gets a lovely sun from here, you know. And then I move it because it's got nice wheels at the bottom. I can move it to the living room. So while we're here, just look at that pomegranate tree. Isn't that gorgeous? So the leaves are falling. It's all yellow right now. I didn't get that many big pomegranates this year. And then this plant also has been moved. I hope this will do well, because I know they don't like to be moved around too much, but I can't risk having this in a different corner of the house because I'm worried that people might forget it and then it's gonna die. That's happened before. And my curry plant has died in the past, but my curry plant is outside. You see that? Oh, and also do look at the leaves, the red leaves that have fallen. Isn't it beautiful? Anyhow, so yeah, that's the curry plant. It's getting some rainwater outside, so I think it should be okay. And November, December, it rains here quite a bit. So let's hope it does okay. All right, California doesn't get super cold, so I don't need to bring it inside, but we'll see, you know. I hope it makes it. Good thing I put this mat underneath and it's dripped all over. If not for the mat, all of this water will be just sitting for days, ruining the wood floor.
I picked up some things to take and a lot of candy, and I was not sure what candy would be ideal to take because it gets really hot in southern India. So this is a video of after I got to Kerala.
I think the hard candies keep really well, as I figured out. Shortbread, yes, hard. Reese's peanut butter has become soft inside, but it's still contained in a pack, so it should be okay. These, yes, have retained their shape beautifully. You know, it's not softened at all in the heat. This again has become soft. Has become soft, but it's still well contained. You can still get it if you want to, but know that it will become soft.
Actually, real quick, guys, that lint didn't really work very well because with time, the chocolate started oozing out. So if you're going to places like Goa or Kerala, you know, down south, then you'll find that when it gets really hot, you'll find that that's not a good pick, because some people say that you can put it in the fridge and it'll be fine. But I think it probably changes the taste a little bit and the texture too. So, but if you're going up north, it'll be perfect. So that didn't work out as well as I would have liked it to.
And then these little wafers wrapped in chocolate also work. They're hard still. So it's just something to keep in mind.
Then, of course, you have to make sure that you have all your documents. I keep mine in this. So, you know, whether it's your visa, your OCI, and of course, your passport, you've got to make sure that's updated.
I have my old passport, new passport, all kinds of things in here. My OCI card, bottles, whatnot, some leftover rupees from earlier. Are these still, or did demonetization get rid of the 500 rupees? I don't know. So something that was lying around, taking all that stuff with me. I'm also taking some of my gold stuff, you know, a little bit. I don't have a lot, but it's all in here because I want to exchange out some pieces and see if I, you know, want to get another piece, if that's possible.
Of course, keep all your valuable stuff in your carry-on bag. I once made the mistake of putting my iPad in my check-in bag from San Francisco to Chicago. And I reached Chicago and it was gone. So since then, I never make that mistake. Medications, yes, check. Gotta put all this in. Let's see, this will be in here. This is for the flight, but yes, you have to make sure all your medications are with you in your carry-on so you don't have to risk losing them. Oh, and then, you know, in Kerala, there are a lot of mosquitoes. So you may have that issue. And for that, you want to take these light, long pajamas is what I have here for the night. And also long sleeves. Sometimes it gets really hot. So you want to stay covered with some light cotton fabric.
Taking spray bottles is such a challenge. So I'm trying something new here. So I took the pump out. It's a, you know, bottle with a pump. And I want to take this to India. And then what I have here is I put a little plastic piece in there. I got a cap from one of my other, I think it was from a nail paint remover that fit perfectly. And so I closed it with a little piece of plastic in between to kind of seal it a little bit. So I'm hoping this will work. So I'll take this separately, put it in a Ziploc and take.
And instead of that lame plastic piece I had, use this one, the Glad Press and Seal, seals beautifully.
I bought this whole jar of mango pickle, my mom's mango pickle, sealed like that, and not one drop of oil spilled.
And then seal it again. You really won't be sorry for being extra cautious. You know, you really don't want to spill, and you don't want to lose all that good moisturizers or, you know, oils or whatever it is that is part of your regimen and you take with you. Or just, you know, you can leave the pumps here at home. Because if it's a short trip, you don't really need the luxury of taking pumps along with you.
So basically, save caps. Some of these caps, you know, they come really handy.
Also, guys, if you find this at Target, if you've seen this and you're wondering whether this is useful, let me tell you, it's really good because it keeps the liquid in and it doesn't pop up and open up because of cabin pressure. So I've used these for my domestic flights and taken liquids in it and it's worked beautifully. So if you find this, get it. And I bought mine as a pack of some other stuff in there, but I didn't use the rest as much as I used this. So go for it. Oh, and then there's the issue of the mail. You can just ask your post office to stop your mail. They'll collect it for you, and then when you're back, you can go pick it up. Then come the garbage cans. Hopefully it's empty. If not, you could ask a friend or neighbor or someone to do that for you. The gardeners are also usually good about it, so they can help you out.
So I'm just cleaning out the fridge. This is a good time to do all that because, you know, I've thrown out everything that's not going to last me till I'm back. A lot of stuff there. So this is a nice time to clean it out. And my husband's going to be here. The kids might come back, so some of the staples I have to leave these tomatoes here, because I think my husband's going to make a chicken curry for himself. But yeah, generally it's a lot more empty. This is a good time to do all these things. Very unlikely for an Indian fridge to be this barren. Only if you're traveling, only if you're going to be away. Oh my god, I hope he eats all these eggs sitting here. Used up whatever remaining vegetables were in the fridge, and I'm going to make a juice out of it.
You can also make vegetable soup. Why have it go waste?
So I took this juicer as a gift for my parents so they could make their vegetable juice with a little bit of fruit in it. But it turned out that it wasn't going to work in India. My husband told me last minute, because this was some 120 volts and 150 watts. I don't know, that's a department I've outsourced to him. So anyhow, it wasn't going to work. So he said he would bring the converter with him when he comes. So you got to make sure that these things, which are gifts or gadgets, will work. I think I got most of the things that I need to throw into my bag last night. Tomorrow. You know, these days I've started taking this because my husband's a big believer in having your own speakers, headphones, having your own headphones. I think I'm going to be all set. So I'll throw all this into my big travel bag tomorrow. I have some chamomile tea in there as well. If they give me some hot water, I can use that. Made sure to take a couple of pens, that'll work. Because, you know, you always need it for all those immigration papers. I think I should be set. So I always take a water bottle with me. So after security check, I refill the water from one of those water fountains. And then, because you have to make sure that you stay hydrated, you know, and then you can't always get water on the flight right away. Hopefully by the time you get to the airport, you've already figured out all your global entry with which you can get TSA pre and then speed through the check-in process. I found that they were really strict, maybe because it was holiday season and the flight was full. They were checking all our bags and they were making sure that it was the restricted weight. Found quite a few people having to shift their luggage around. Also, your priority pass, if you want lounge access. My husband was telling me that we get it through our credit card, so we don't need to buy it. So that helps, you know. In the US, it's not really much. You'll at least get sandwich if you're lucky. But what I found was that priority pass really came handy in India at the Bangalore airport. Oh my god, we had a layover, for overnight layover, and we had the best meals in there. So it definitely works really well in India, even at the Cochin airport. Okay, I think I have it all together. Let's hope. My first trip by myself after my kids have flown the nest. Empty nester ready to take off.
Right on the wing.
Is it good or bad to be on the wing? I don't know. I'll find out. So guys, if you liked that video, do like and subscribe and come back and see more. See what I did in India. It was a lot of fun. I think the whole family agreed that it was one of their best vacations ever. One of their best times going back to India. So I think you'll like it too. So come back and see a lot of Kerala.